of heaven is like a grain of a mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in the field, which indeed is the least of all seeds, but when it is grown, it is the greatest among herbs. It becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air may come and lodge in the branches thereof. Elesulu lithi, it's Matthew 13, verse number 31. Matthew 13, verse 31. Ikhuluma ngombuso kaNkulunkulu. Verse number 31, lesizulu lizothi, omunye umfanekiso wawubeka kubo wathi, umbuso wezulu ufana nenhlamvu yesinaphi ayithatha umuntu wayehlwanyela tsimini yakhe. Yona kambe incinyana kunazo zonke izimbewu, kepha uma isikhulile inkulu kunezilimo, iba ngumuthi kuze kufike izinyoni zezulu zakhele emagatsheni awo. Now, I want us to understand ukuthi uma sizonikela, we basically speaking about the seed. Sikhuluma ngembewu ukuthi kumele sitshale. But uJesu ukhuluma lana ukuthi ke umbuso wezulu ufana nembewu eyatshalwa umuntu, ebese ethi le mbewu incane, ibukeka incane kunazo zonke izimbewu ezikhona, but the man sowed the seed. Now ngiyayithanda le nto ukuthi likhuluma ukuthi ifana nendoda eyathatha imbewu yayitshala. Now you need to understand ukuthi awukwazi ukuba nembewu bese ungayitshali. The effectiveness of a seed is when the seed is sown. Amandla embewu asekuthenini imbewu itshalwe. So no matter how much you may have, when God calls it a seed, you must understand ukuthi kumele uyitshale. Ungakaqhubekeli naphambili, the reason why people struggle so much in life is because they don't live on harvest. I've realized ukuthi isizathu sokuthi abantu bezabalaze kangako, beze bekhulume ngobunzima ezimpilweni zabo, ingoba baphili ngesivuno, kodwa baphila ngembewu engatshaliwe. People live on unsown seed instead of living on harvest. Awuthaleni amen. That's the greatest problem with abantu baphila ngembewu engatshaliwe instead of ukuphila ngesivuno. Iplan nedesign kaNkulunkulu ngempilo yakho ukuthi ungaphili ngembewu. Iplan nedesign kaNkulunkulu empilweni yakho ukuthi uphile ngesivuno. Now, if it is still limited, uma kuseyinto nawe engakunelisi, that is a seed. Because a harvest becomes plenty. So if it is not plenty, it is still a seed. Now the uma uzothatha leyo nto encane engakwenelisi bese uyitshela ukuthi uzophila ngayo, you are putting yourself in danger of struggling more. Because kusho ukuthi wena awuphili ngesivuno, uphila ngembewu engatshaliwe. Nisekhona bazalwane. Now, in 2008, I visited another church in Newcastle, and so this church was on TV, some of the Shalapans, but then with TV, with ETV, and then what that would be, let's ask that, but when you're going to make innovations, the band came, because JMA Bevela TV, Velelash. So ngiyenxa ukuthi ke kusafuneka wenza ama-renovations, umfundisi wayesecela ukuthi ama-recordings la wenza ku-TV bengasabashuthe esontweni, babashuthe kwa-ETV. So wayeya khona beshuthe khona. And this is what happens ukuthi ke wayesethi bane-project yama-renovations ukuthi kufuneke be-raise ku-3 million. Kwenziwa amagroup kamagroup, wahlanganiswa-ke kuthiwa-ke
will raise up to 3 million. Now, what if you just cut the target here, ungahlangene u 3 million. And then kwahlangana u 2.5 million. And then ngiyakhumbula ukuthi umfundisi maye emaphambili wathi isikhathi sishayile besifuna ukuhlanganisa u 3 million for the renovations. But imali esihlanganisile it's about 2.5. So kusho ukuthi ke uNkulunkulu sifake esikhatini sokuthi lo 2.5 million akusiyo imali yama renovations. But lo 2.5 million imali yembeyo. Now, wherever he went, wherever he went, you would just sign a check of 300,000 and sow it. And people were saying he is crazy because they were actually thinking, how can you raise so much money? And then short of 500,000, and everywhere he went, I remember there were churches that were building, and he would sign 500,000 and say, as you are building. Now, when you look at that man from that time until now, God has opened up a radio station for him. God has opened up a stadium for him to possess. Now you are realizing, because he decided to sow a seed, now God has opened up a harvest that is greater than what he was sowing. Until you decide, because the Bible, a man sowed the seed, and then walala wavuka yamila engazi ukuthi kanjani. Na uma usutshalile akusikho kwakho ukuthi wazi ukuthi izophuma nini, izomila nini, harvestisa nini. Okwakho ukuthi utshale ukuthi izoba iharvest kanjani akusikho kwakho, but okwakho ukuthi utshale. Tshela umakhawunti okwakho makhelwane ukuthi utshale. After you have sown a seed, there is harvest that's going to come out, and you will not be able to explain how. But Obokina said, Shala Paz, little Bible lamb, Yaisiba is slash. Uma is slash, besekuthiwa inyoni zezulu zasuka zazodlala zaphela esihlahleni. Hayi, khona oyedwa ongizwile. Akekho umuntu ongathi unecapacity yokufuya into endizayo. Into endizayo, akekho umuntu onecapacity yokuyifuya njengembuzi nenkomo. Ukuthi kunesikhathi sokungena kwazo esibayeni nesokuphuma kwazo. Kodwa umuntu otshale imbewu yamila yayisihlahla, ukwazi ukucontrola ngisho izinto ey'ndizayo.
Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Even as we are coming to sow this morning, this night, thank you for increase. Thank you for blessing. Thank you for grace that abounds forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.